Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for August the 25th of 2020, well, it is titled Visualization, a Black Hole Accretion Disk. So what do we see here? Well, this is a way to visualize the accretion disk around a black hole. Now, the black hole would be at the center, not the entire dark spot. In fact, you can see that labeled on the initial image as the black hole shadow, which is actually an area much larger than the black hole itself, about twice the size of the actual event horizon, which is the point beyond which we cannot know anything about the black hole. But that is all area that is blocked out because light rays are captured. Gravitational lensing bends light out of that area, so we see nothing in that inner region. The outer part, the parts that glow in the red and orange, are actually the accretion disk. Now, the accretion disk itself would be a flat disk, but you can see in the initial image how it is distorted. And the distortions are caused by the gravity of the black hole. And in fact, down below, you see an image of the underside of the disk. So you're seeing part of the disk being where the light has been bent around the black hole and now comes to us from a completely different direction. So the black hole itself is distorting space around it so much that light particles, we call photons, do not follow the ordinary straight lines that we would expect in normal space. But they actually follow the shortest path within the curved space, and in fact the very distorted space around the black hole. So that can cause multiple images. We can see the underside of the ring, and we can see how the far side of the ring is actually bent upward towards the top. So even though the disk itself would be flat, the appearance to us here on Earth is this great distortion because of that gravity of the black hole. Now, if you also notice, the left-hand side is much brighter and the right-hand side is much darker. That is due to the Doppler effect, where the Doppler shift from material coming towards us is going to be make things appear brighter, and things moving away from us are going to appear fainter. So it's not that one side of the ring is brighter or fainter, but that the one side is moving towards us and therefore being magnified, and the other side is moving away from us and therefore its intensity is just diminishing. Now, as I said, this is actually a video, so we can play the video as well and take a look at that. And we'll see it. It starts out with the same original image, and then we will tilt up towards looking at it from 90 degrees, looking straight down on the black hole, and then tilt around the other direction. And that gives us a chance. When we look on it 90 degrees, it tends to look a lot more normal, not completely, but closer to what we would see in an ordinary disk. You can see that the bright and dark areas have kind of disappeared when you see that. And the disk is nowhere near as distorted as it is when we're looking at it edge on. When we look at it edge on, as we saw in our initial image, it is completely distorted out of place by the gravitation of a black hole. Now, of course, a black hole can never be seen directly, but we are actually being able to image some of the accretion disks around a black hole by the Event Horizon Telescope, which actually is giving us far more detail and far more understanding of black holes than we have ever had before. So that was our picture of the day for August the 25th of 2020. It was titled Visualization, a Black Hole Accretion Disk. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Swan and Galaxy. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.